Hello everyone. In this demo, I would like to show you how you can extract any critical path or nets in your design and have RFPro efficiently analyze them with EM circuit co-simulation and without any layout modification or cookie cutting. Let me show you how. The RF module and interconnect routing I'm using here consist of a silicon-based RF transceiver chip and a gallium arsenide filter, a multi-technology assembly on a fan-out wafer-level package. The transceiver IC is flipped and placed on top of a fan-in redistribution process layer, we call RDL, and connected with solder balls and routed through a fan-out multi-layer wafer-level package. Now, one reason for the solder balls connection is to reduce or eliminate the high loss and parasitic associated with traditional bond wires connections, especially in higher frequency application. But notice here, I used on the other IC chip, which is the GaAs gallium arsenide filter IC, it has bond wires connection. I used bond wires here just to illustrate to you the richness of mixed multi-technologies assembly and simulation in ADS. So here's a picture of the final assembly. Now let me demo this in ADS and RFPro. Here's the workspace in ADS. First, let me open the transceiver IC pad ring layout, which is basically the footprint of the transceiver chip, and it has all the external connection pins. For example, here are the differential output pins of the PA in the transceiver. Please pay attention to this gap or the space between the pins on the right side of the pad ring. But this pad ring will be sitting on top of a redistribution layer, RDL, and notice the RDL has its gap on the left side, as shown here. But because the IC pad ring is configured to be mounted as flip chip, the gap on each one of them, when assembled together, will perfectly align. Here you can see in the P-cell customization of the IC pad ring, the layout is set to smart mount flip chip, as shown here. So now, when I mount the IC onto the RDL, it should align properly because the IC has been flipped, as you see here. Next, from the main window, let me now open the fan-out wafer-level package schematic and layout views. At the right side panel of the layout page, the differences window is showing that this page is still missing the IC and RDL designs. So as you see here, I can easily drag them in and place them at the middle and on top of the wafer level package, as shown here. The flight lines you see here will help guide me on where the interconnects must go in order to match with the schematic. So now I will use trace routing in order to perform the connections. Notice the routing also has automatic collision avoidance. This prevents lines on the same layer to collide or short, and also help avoid breaking any DRC rules. To save time, let me now open the completed routed module. And here it is. All the pins have been connected, and the module is now completely routed and ready for EM analysis with RFPro. Now, let me launch RFPro from the Tools menu. In this demo, I want to perform a user-defined analysis on the interconnect routing between the output nodes of the power amplifier and the input nodes of the filter. To do that, I simply select the interconnect nets between the PA and the filter and move them down into the user-defined analysis section, as shown here. Let me switch to wireframe visibility mode for better viewing. And here you can now see the two interconnects that I would like to analyze and check for their impedance match and insertion loss. The two nets' names are highlighted on the interconnects coming from the PA output nodes. Next, in the Options tab, I define the simulation frequencies and I select the type of EM analysis. In my case, I chose the 3D Generation 2 FEM simulator. Next, I would go ahead and run the simulation. And I have already performed the simulation run for you, and I wanted to show you the summary page. You can see it took close to 2 minutes to complete the simulation on my laptop. Now, let's look at the results. You can immediately view the S parameters results by clicking on it in the Results tab. Here I'm plotting the input and output return loss, S11, S22, S33, and S44, of the four nodes of the two interconnects, so we can see how good the impedance match is. And it shows here that we have better than 15 dB return loss at 2 GHz. Next, I want to display the S21 and S43, which are the insertion loss of the interconnects. And here they are. So you can see the loss of these two lines are shown to be less than 0.4 dB at 2 GHz. This is important because we don't want these lines to have a higher loss than required, since any additional loss would take away expensive power from the PA output and reduce it. I hope you have enjoyed watching this demo. But please, I want you to remember that these user-defined analysis of critical nets or sections in your layout are done without having to modify the layout or cookie-cut it. It is all done by selecting the nets and moving them down in the analysis section of RFPro, as I have just shown. Thank you for watching.